guys! Today I'm going to talk to you all about how I take notes in a math class. Math has always been a really tough subject for me, but recently I've kind of made my own system on how I take notes while I'm in math class, and it's helped me a lot, so I hope it helps you guys too. When I take notes in math class, I usually just use loose leaf paper, and I also like to use my Staedtler Tri-Plus Fineliners. I've talked about these so much, they're my favorite pens to use. And so usually I have four colors. Three of them are next to each other on the color wheel and are very similar, and then the fourth color complements the other three. So I use that fourth color for just the title and the section number of my notes. And so that section number is the subchapter in my textbook, and I just put a little cloud around it. So all of my notes have that and it stays very consistent. And in addition to that, I use the other three shades of purple for the rest of my notes. I use the darkest shade to write down the example problems, and I denote that with an X with a circle around it. And I write out like definitions with that and things like that. And then the lighter shade of purple is what I use for defining terms, for working out example problems, and writing whatever my teacher writes on the board. And that third color, which is the bright pink in this case, I write down any extra notations that the teacher may have not written on the board, but it is something that was said or a step that we take. And I find that that third step is super useful when I'm taking notes, because that way when I go back to look at this while doing like homework or studying, I understand what went on in class and I'm not like clueless as to how we got to the last answer or what we substituted in. So having that extra bit of information that you add in from what the teacher is saying instead of simply what's being written on the board is super helpful for me when I'm going back for my math notes. In addition to that, I'm in AP Calculus. And so whenever we practice AP multiple choice questions, I always denote that in the margin so that way I can double check with my understanding of that problem in relation to the easier examples we've talked about. And finding like a specific way you denote certain things is super useful and I found helps me be very successful in a math class. Unlike my other subjects, math requires a lot of graphs. And so whenever you're required to create graphs in your notes, it's always a really good idea to utilize what you have with you at the moment. So I always take advantage of the fact that I have lines in my loose leaf paper. And so I always make my graphs only 4 lines tall and about that much wide. And that's usually enough space for me to create a quick sketch of what the function is supposed to look like. And if you ever have to graph more than one function, like doing inverse trig derivatives and things like that, you can take advantage of the fact that you are using more than one color by doing one function in one color and write that corresponding equation towards the margin of the paper and do the same for the other function, so that way you're able to see both in relation to each other. Thanks for watching. If you guys like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel because I'll be posting new videos every Wednesday. And please be sure to check out my Tumblr and 8 Tracks. Bye, guys!